Today on the Trey Art Channel, I will be talking about folate. Stick around. Welcome to the Trey Art Channel. I am Ray Upchurch, your host, and this is the 12th part of the Essential Vitamin and Mineral Series. Folate, also known as vitamin B9 and formerly known as folicin, is a water-soluble vitamin. The reason you need folate is to make DNA, RNA, and red blood cells. Fortunately, folate deficiency is uncommon, especially by itself. But when it does occur, it usually coexists with other nutrient deficiencies. The symptoms of folate deficiency include weakness, fatigue, difficulty concentrating, irritability, headache, heart palpitations, and weight loss. In women that are pregnant who also have insufficient folate intake, they are at risk of having babies that have neurotube deficits. Low maternal folate also has been associated with low birth weight and preterm delivery, also fetal growth retardation. The groups at risk of being folate deficient are alcoholics, people with malabsorption problems, and people on dialysis. It is recommended that pregnant and lactating women ensure that they are taking adequate amounts of folate to reduce the chances of neural tube deficits and other birth deficits. Now, when it comes to the recommended daily allowance of folate, it should be noted that these are in regards to the dietary folate equivalent. The recommended daily allowance of folate for children between 0 to 6 months is 65 micrograms, and for children between 7 to 12 months, it is 80 micrograms. The recommended intake for children between 1 to 3 years old is 150 micrograms, and for children 4 to 8 years old, it's 200 micrograms. For 9 to 13 years old, it's 300 micrograms. For adolescents and adults 14 years and older, it's 400 micrograms. Unless they're pregnant, then it's 600 micrograms, or if they're lactating, it's 500 micrograms. The top 10 list of foods highest in folate are green soybeans with 121% the daily value per cup, lentils with 90% per cup, asparagus at 67% per cooked cup, spinach at 66% per cooked cup, broccoli at 42% per cooked cup, avocados at 41% per avocado, mangoes at 18% per cup, lettuce at 16% per cup, sweet corn at 15% per cooked cup, and oranges at 14% per cup. The risk of folate excess are a little unclear. Some concerns have been raised that it might accelerate the progression of prenucleonic lesions, which might increase the risk of colorectal or other cancers. Also, it is thought that the periconception doses of 1,000 micrograms per day or more might be responsible for lowering the cognitive development score in children at 4 to 5 years old. It should be noted that some people cannot absorb the supplemental form of folate, and in these people, if they take the supplemental form, it will actually lower the amount of folate that they can absorb from the food. Also, folate can have interactions with medications such as methotrexate, antileptic medications, and sulfasalazine, just to name a few. As with any medications or vitamins, please consult your doctor before taking any of them. And remember, the best way to get any vitamin is through eating a variety of foods. So, how do you get your folate? Let me know in the comment section below, and don't forget to join me for the Walk 52 Challenge. If you've liked this content, please press the like button below. Don't forget to subscribe. See you again.